What's going on, guys? Welcome back to WWE Pit. Today we are counting down the top 8 Paul Heyman guys of all time. First up at number 8, the Midnight Express. Midnight Express, Dennis Condrey and Randy Rose were managed by Paul Heyman at this point, and while Heyman had a massive effect on their overall career, it was a short-lived cooperation. Heyman's manager role worked a bit too well when it came to the Midnight Express. After all, everyone involved got babyface status, even Jim Cornette. At the end of the day, this could have gotten much bigger if Condrey did not leave the promotion when he did. Nevertheless, it made our list of the most notable Paul Heyman managed groups. At number 7, Stone Cold Steve Austin. When Steve Austin was a Paul Heyman guy, he did not find himself yet. Long before his Texas Rattlesnake days, Stone Cold was just like any other wrestler out there. Of course, Paul Heyman saw something in Stone Cold not everyone else did. When it comes to an eye for talent, nobody can deny that Heyman certainly has that eye. The real success of Stone Cold Steve Austin did not come until that epic King of the Ring moment. Nevertheless, Paul Heyman saw something in Stone Cold many years before his huge successes in WWE. At number 6, Rick Rude. While most remember ravishing Rick Rude as a standout, ravishing guy, he was also one of the top Paul Heyman guys. This makes you wonder if there is a major star Heyman hasn't promoted. Now, Rick Rude and Heyman's cooperation was not the most prominent in this list. Nevertheless, Paul did make his transition to a standalone competitor more smooth. Before Heyman, Rude was a part of the Heenan family. With Paul Heyman, it seemed like he found his standalone footing a bit easier. At number 5, Eddie Gilbert. The cooperation between Eddie Gilbert and Paul Heyman changed the wrestling landscape forever. Unfortunately, not every modern wrestling fan is aware of this particular story. Eddie Gilbert and Heyman met and became friends in the mid-80s, and this friendship paid off in ECW. When Gilbert and Heyman joined forces, they brought a much more violent and edgier product to television. Many believe that this was the true start of the Attitude Era that led to a wrestling world transformation. Unfortunately, Gilbert never got to enjoy the revolution he started, and the pro wrestler died of a heart attack in his apartment in Isla Verde, Puerto Rico. At number 4, The Big Show. While The Big Show does not need that much support to succeed in wrestling, he was a Paul Heyman guy at one point. In fact, Big Show actually did 3 separate stints along Heyman. Big Show had separate stints with Heyman in 2002, 03, and 06, and this influence of Heyman was noticeable, as his bookings visibly improved with Heyman by his side. Of course, the sky's the limit for the Big Show these days. Not only is he a WWE legend, he also has his own comedy TV show these days. At the end of the day, the Big Show did not really need Paul Heyman, just like Roman Reigns, but Heyman certainly helped to give the Big Show the position he deserved among heavy competition. At number 3, CM Punk. Out of all the Paul Heyman guys in wrestling history, CM Punk was the one who sparked magic. Heyman and Punk formed a duo that would be difficult to recapture in the future. Interestingly, Punk and Heyman had a good bond outside of their on-screen cooperation. In fact, both men had fought each other's battles backstage. Heyman was always in Punk's corner, especially when it came to convincing Vince McMahon. CM Punk's pipebomb from 2011 also included a number of references to Paul Heyman. At number 2, Roman Reigns. While this friendship is relatively new, he is certainly a prominent name to add to this list. Indeed, Roman Reigns took over the mantle of Cena as the face of the company. By becoming one of the WWE Paul Heyman guys, Roman Reigns also changed his persona. In fact, he returned to his Shield roots as a heel. Reigns enjoyed a great return since the coronavirus pandemic. Indeed, he captured the Universal Championship and put the Fiend on the proverbial bench. And at number 1, you guessed it, Brock Lesnar. Heyman has been accompanying Brock Lesnar since 2002, and there's no denying that he has been one of the most successful WWE Paul Heyman guys of all time. While the Beast went to the UFC during his wrestling career, he has always been a major attraction in pro wrestling. Since his return in 2012, he has pretty much been unstoppable with Heyman by his side. We'll have to see what's going to happen if and when Brock Lesnar returns with Paul Heyman. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching this video of WWE Pit. If you enjoyed, do me a favor and hit that like button, subscribe, and hit that bell so you guys never miss an upload. We got some fire ones coming out soon, and I'll see you beautiful faces in the next video. Stay safe, and have a fantastic day.